Hearings ambazo zimeshatoka shilingi zimeenda hearings 8 of 2020, 10 of 2020.
So you can see background information.
Yeah.
We may not understand.
We may not understand.
It.
Yes. Let me explain to you.
Yes.
So information.
How approximation. We are not going to hold you to our.
Approximation. It means
we are trying to deal with it. We went up to the Council of Ministers on Wednesday. Where they make judges come and hear.
Yes.
So unless a matter.
Sasa alafu. Mimi date mtapatiana after hizo 45 days kiela sababu.
Normally we don't give dates after 45 days, okay, that's... You know, you should understand the mahakama, the judge have a couple of them. They come... accompany me, as proof.
So, tuende na hii ama nikuache?
Nisa niwache tulete.
It is something that will cost me like 30 minutes.
It's a one page, I think it's a one page.
It's a one page document.
Yeah. You have the rules?
I have the rules. Niko na hii
hapa? Oh, uko na hii.
78.
78. Si, utatuhuzo tuichukue picha, ndo tusikosa
tena. Na ijo. It's just a normal of event of service.
And una attach is kwa hiyo affidavit inakuwa next chapter.
Okay. That one I can prepare it.
Yeah.
Within 30 minutes.
I'm a left of service saying that I so and so went to the office of the Attorney General and found so and so who acknowledged receipts
on the service.
The service.
There's no
because if you look at our rules,
yeah.
We need to file that.
Bunge la wananchi.
Nguvu mashinani.
Bunge la wananchi.
Nguvu mashinani.
Thank you very much. My name is Comrade Bush. I'm the Attorney General and the custodian of legal instruments of Bunge la wananchi. So we have just emerged from a lengthy meeting with the judges hosted by the judges of the First Division of East African Court of Justice and attended by the high-ranking officials of Bunge la wananchi to discuss pertinent issues relating to the case filed by Bunge la Mwananchi here at the East African Court of Justice Arusha that are key to ensure administration of justice is achieved within specific timelines. It is very clear from the discussion that we have had with the judges that there's need to fast track the prosecution of the matter that is before this court, and key issues have emerged from this meeting that we wish to tell the nation and the community at large. Number one, issue number one that has been discussed is compliance by the parties to the directions of the court. And in this regard, Bunge la Mwananchi has filed an affidavit of service to affirm that it is ready and compliant to the directions and orders of the court. And we have 45 days that the judges have clearly stated that the Republic of Kenya has to file a substantive response to the allegations that have been put forward by Bunge la Mwananchi and the first petitioner, the president of Bunge la Mwanachi, Francis Awino. Regarding the state compliance, the Republic of Kenya compliance with the orders and directions of the court, the judges have affirmed that they will exercise their jurisdiction appropriately and without prejudice, and ensure that the Republic of Kenya complies with the directions that the court has issued, so that within 45 days it shall have put in a substantive response to the allegations filed by Bunge la Mwanachi, failure to which they have equally stated that they are willing to assert necessary sanctions to ensure that the orders of the court are obeyed. Secondly, we have also put in an application seeking to introduce more evidence that we have received from parts of Githurai, other evidence that we have received from Madare of forceful evictions. We have also put in an application to introduce new evidence that we have received from Kiambio slums. All this strengthen our case, presenting a high level of possibility of convicting individuals who are accused of command responsibility for the crimes that were perpetrated within the Republic of Kenya. We have also put in an application for the indictment of five individuals that we believe that bear the greatest responsibility, so that they are individually held culpable for the atrocities that were perpetrated against the people of Kenya. The individuals we will mention for so that there is no doubt. Number one is William Ruto, who is the President of the Republic of Kenya. Number two is the Honorable Rigathi Gachagua, the Deputy President. Number three, Japheth Koome, former IG. Number four is Adamson Bungei, the current Commander of Police of Nairobi Region, and Honorable Kithure Kindiki. So we have told the court that there is need for these people to be indicted as soon as possible, because there are ongoing spate of abductions and other criminal activities that are still being witnessed within the territory of the Republic of Kenya under their supervision. So we want them to be brought here as soon as possible, so that even the witnesses and the evidence that is still not collected is not interfered with. Because we are planning as Bunge la Mwanachi to go and meet the victim, so that we can preserve the integrity of evidence that is still on the ground. We wish to make it very clear and reassure the nation that the case that we have filed against the Republic of Kenya here at the East African Court of Justice is proceeding with flawless precision, and there is hope that when we invoke all the instruments within the domestic jurisdiction and regional jurisdiction, and if possible, we are ready to even invoke legal instruments at the international level to ensure that the culture of impunity, the culture of those who hold political positions and perpetrate impunity in a manner that they cannot be held accountable for their crime, comes to an end here in Kenya. So as Bunge la Mwanachi, we are optimistic that within 45 days, we will look at what the Republic of Kenya shall have filed. But from what, as it stands now, all the response that we have, that we anticipate that will be brought before this court, will be based on falsehoods, because we have collected primary evidence that implicates the Republic of Kenya directly, plus the individuals whose names we have mentioned. So we hope that the judges will convene as soon as possible, so that the spate of abductions and forceful evictions that are still being witnessed in Kenya to date are brought to an end as soon as possible. Thank you very much.
Bunge la Mwanachi. Bunge la Mwanachi. My name is Francis Awino. I'm the current president Bunge la Mwanachi, and at the same time, I'm the people's president in our Republic of Kenya. We came here like 2-3 weeks ago. We filed our application, and we were given orders, which we went back to our country and served. And now the government was given 45 days. So that they can respond to our application. They have until date 7 October so that they can file in their response. I'm saddened today when I heard news that one of the student leaders were arrested because of the planned demonstration, and Article 37 gave us a right to do so. I'm saddened again after I heard that one of my friends, Bomb Jaggi, was arrested after trying to mobilize people so that they can collect signature to out our president, William Samoei Ruto. And since we are in the court of justice, where we believe we shall find justice, we even feel like we won't wait until October 7. We are going to file an application and a certificate of urgency so that we can get orders which will bar our government and our rogue police officers from violating our constitution. And we believe the way we came here at first and found justice through the first orders, we believe still we shall find justice towards the people that their rights are being violated. We believe we shall find an answer, and we have hope in this court. And as the saying says, that there is always a light at the end of the tunnel. We have already found our light here in this court, and we believe that those people who are murdered, those people who are forcefully evicted, those people who are forcefully arrested, it is the last time it is being done in Kenya. Because we believe we shall find orders which shall be abided by the people that are in power. And this thing that these people in Kenya usually do, that when you are in power you feel you are like you are above the law. And this action that you believe, when you are the president of our country Kenya, you cannot be taken to court because you enjoy that immunity. We are putting that to an end. And that's why we are saying, rather than you coming to Tanzania and remaining here, because we know in Tanzania there are courts, in Tanzania there are cells, in Tanzania there are jails, you can start negotiating right now. Because after 7th October, you won't be going back to Kenya. And we shall leave you here so that you can answer the crimes that you have committed. We are telling the people of our nation, we have hope and we shall find justice here. We just want you to remain patient. When we come back to Kenya, we shall move around collecting other evidence that we need. And if you feel like you have anything, if you feel like you have anything that will help us in this court, if you feel like police violated your rights, and if any bullet passed to your body and you're struggling, we are asking for all those evidence so that in the other application that we shall be filing so that we can protect our constitution, you can be part of that evidence. Thank you very much. May God bless Kenya, and may God bless all of us, and may God bless Africa at large. Thank you.
Bunge la mwananchi,
nguvu mashinani.
Bunge la mwananchi,
nguvu mashinani.
Asante. Mimi naitwa Morris Masiga, Deputy President Bunge la Mwananchi. Tuko katika hii kesi ile ambayo tulileta hapa Arusha Mahakama ya East African Court. Vile AG alipokea zile summons tulimpelekea, ndio tunaambia wale ambao waliparticipate katika kupiga watu risasi kwa hii demonstration, bwana President of the Republic of Kenya, Deputy President, na wengine wote na maskari wote ambao walipigwa watu risasi, tafadhali wajiandae kukuja hapa kujitetea vile walifanya hiyo maneno kule hapo Kenya. Mupange kesi yenu, mupange kila kitu yenu, tukutane hapa Arusha, kwa sababu hapa Arusha mambo yamechemuka na meli imeng'oa nanga. Wameangalia hiyo kesi na wamesema muko na kesi ya kujibu. Na ndio maana tunasisitiza, tafadhali, vile sisi tumejipanga na watu wetu ambao ni mashahidi, nyinyi pia pangeni kwa sababu muko na kesi ya kujibu. Tukirudi Kenya, next time tukirudi hapa, President na battalion yako yote, tafadhali, mkijua mkikuja hapa, either mtatoka ama hamutatoka. Na ndio maana tunasisitiza, tunasema, vile muli mobilize jana ma president wengine wa East Africa kutafuta kiti ya AU, ndio the same mobilize kuile outcome ya hii kesi itatoka. Kama itatoka, tafadhali mjimobilize na mkuje mseme mmekubaliana na mahakama. Hakuna njia ingine, hiyo ndio njia peke yake ya kusaidia wale victim na kukomesha hii tabia ya mtu akiwa kwa power, yeye na watu wake wakiwa kwa power anafanya nini? Atu wanaangamiza wananchi na wanapiga watu risasi na wanaua watu na hamisha watu kwa manyumba zao na kuwabomolea na kufanya mambo mengine yote maovu. Tunakomesha hapo, na ndio maana tunasema tunataka justice, 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 justice.